us to mounting up a high, highly elevated mountain where they have, for they were fortunate enough to witness the transfigured Christ in dazzling light. Peter, James and John, they have witnessed the people from the past, Elijah, Moses and Elijah, were conversing to our Lord transfigured Christ. They fell into a trance. And then Peter said, "It is good for us to be here, but we will make three tents, one for you, Moses and Elijah." But Lord didn't make them to stay there. They were brought down. All the three first Gospels give this narrative beautifully. You know, this tells us, and we celebrate this as a feast on 6th of August in our tradition. There are a few things about this, and I would like to connect it to our joy and happiness. First of all, when we ascend into the higher elevated places, our vision changes, our horizon changes. We will have a broader view of things. Our perspective changes. We will have certainly a different approach to what we see. The view will be better. The spiritual life is just the same. We are supposed to be ascending up. Progress in ascension, that is what the church fathers said. And when the beloved disciples had the vision of the transfigured Christ, along with the presence of the fourth generation, Peter made a statement saying that, "I will make a tent, one for you, one for Moses, one for Elijah." The vision of the transfigured Christ will always help us to sheltering ours while we will not start thinking selfishly about ourselves. That is a different approach in life. Rather than always selfishly looking into our own needs, in the presence of the transfigured Christ, will we only look into the needs of others, that is, to which that we have been called into in our life. That's the very purpose of our life. Providing shelter, providing food is kindness. It's an act of compassion, and our communities are very well known for it, especially in providing food, which we have exemplified even for this morning. You fed us, which is an act of kindness. The hands which serves food deserves kissing. It is so compassionate. Well, anyway, that is not the point. Precisely, what helps us in plucking away selfishness from our heart is the presence of the transfigured Christ. And moreover, when everything is over, still, they wanted to be around. They couldn't see Moses and Elijah after a little while. And one of the early church fathers had given a beautiful interpretation for it. For us, Christ is everything. Christ is alone. Christ is a prophet for us. Christ is a God for us. Moses represents the law. Elijah represents the prophecy, prophet. But for the transfigured Christ, everything is contained. Everyone, everything is contained in Christ. Prophecy, law, the law, everything is in Christ. What a great vision it is. What a great interpretation it is. For us, everything is Christ, or everything should be Christ. He is our salvation. He is our Redeemer. He is our truth. He is our way. He is our resurrection. He is the embodiment of love and compassion. He is our guide, master, and teacher. mentor. And finally, they felt that it is better that we should be here. This is what something that we should be experiencing in our worship.